us, we can lose. No, no better than news. When I hear shit,
the Vanu sovereignty is taking control of Ethemir.
Can't place one in front of the strike because of him. I don't know if you can hear me or not, but you could probably try to squeeze a wall, a solid wall, right behind over the strike in front of my blast wall on the ramps if you want. I did lay down tank mines where he was just at, so hopefully the tank mines will get him. I can get rid of the bunkers if you like. I'm just using them as extra walls. And also, please don't repair the terminals in the bunkers because I don't want infills to hack it. Yeah, I do a lot of base building. I'm actually a streamer as well, so but yeah, I do tons of base building. I use ramps just for that reason, you know, to add like a extra layer of wall on the sides of the blast wall. Yeah, man, Wolf1617 is my YouTube and Twitch, so you can look those videos up. That's all I mainly focus on is just base building and finding ways of how to secure the base, make sure it doesn't like go down so fast. Only downside base building is you really gotta babysit it all the time. Yeah, no problem, buddy. There's not that many videos. Actually, there's hardly any videos of other people that stream about base building. So that's the reason why I do it. So I think you might enjoy the videos and stuff. And I'm not done. I'm never done. So there's going to be some videos that are going to be repetitive just because of the way I base build. But this area, I've done it before, but it was really hard to do it the first time. So this is actually my second time doing this spot. And I really like it how it turned out. What I do, I can go on for a long time. I don't know how much time you got, but maybe it'd be best if you watch the stream when you get a chance. But yeah, I can show you ways to base build, how to base build with the infiltrator, like all sorts of techniques, how to harvest cordium without having to sit there forever. Oh yeah, I got a lot, tons of ways to help you. The number one thing I focus on is the Sunday garage. I call it the main core setup and just making sure it's really compact. I always put the claymores on the side where I know the enemy will come from for the most part, and I always put a Spitfire turret in the garage, and I usually put it on top of the repair module because the paint spire with the Spitfire turret does a really good job. And then I put the router on top of the garage. Oh, dude, I do tons of base building, dude. Like, some crazy locations that are even harder to build. For example, Squad Waypoint, it's in the VS territory. I built a base under that bridge, and that base is really hard to build. Yeah, I don't know if you've ever been to that bridge, but right underneath that bridge is literally all slanted hills. There's a few spots that are flat, where I can put the garage at. Normally I would like try to keep the Sundi in here, but I always used a deployment shield Sundi because the repair Sundi does not repair the turrets anymore. And look right over here. Come this way if you want. And I try to put stuff underneath this vehicle pad. Like, for example, I'm going to put the alarm module in front of this repair module. I don't know why it keeps disappearing, but... I don't know why it disappears. Yeah, you don't want to put too many things under this vehicle pad just because the enemy can get in. And the reason why I put the alarm module out there, one, it notifies me if someone's 100 meters or less into the base, and it protects the repair module from where I'm standing. Not necessarily where you're at, but it does do its job. And I always lock all the turrets, but, you know, because they actually do a really good job at close range. The infantry turret is definitely what I lock the most. The AV turret I usually just keep it unlocked, and same thing with the AA, but definitely the infantry turret, I always lock it. It's so OP at close range. And if you can confine the base and try to funnel the enemy to two directions or one direction, what does locking it do? It makes it so no one can get into it. Because there's nothing like a regular player get into it and cannot do, you know, their job. Ammunition here. But the key to base building, in my opinion, it's just my opinion, is make sure everything's so together, compacted, because you only got three repair modules. And it's okay to have, like, the Sunday garage is being repaired by two different modules, the one that's inside the garage and the one that's underneath the vehicle pad. Like, you gotta think, like, where the enemy is gonna come from, how do you want the enemy to get into your base, and, like, I'm a very strategy guy. Like, I think you'll like the videos, because I go so in-depth. Yeah, next level. Yeah, like, I'm actually going to be given base score, which is 1 through 10, and I give the pros and cons for each area I build, and I've been starting to do that. I haven't been posting videos about it, but I'm going to be doing it for this base. So, like the pros is, we're under the bridge, but the bad part is you can put tank mines on the sky shield and, like, do some damage, or have vehicles drop down, you know, stuff like that. Like, that's just, and then the cons is it's hard to get lots of vehicles deployed just because of where the vehicle's pad is at. But I designed it this way because, one, that's the only way it fits. And two, when the enemy hacks the vehicle turret, look right here. Look at what the vehicle turret is and look what the infantry turret is. When they try to hack it, they're going to get shot by the infantry turret. So you got to think, like, how's the enemy going to try and hack and stuff? Oh yeah, dude, I can go on and on, dude. I don't know how much time you got, but I can go on about base building. I got lots of places that I like to build, and sometimes I'm repetitive. Hold on. It's okay, it's just a liberator, we're good. He's not gonna get in. He's thinking about it, though. But, like, you know, you just gotta think about, like, how's the enemy gonna get in and stuff like that. And I got the wall up here. Make it so the harassers can't squeeze through. Or any GSD vehicles. Same thing with the wall on this side. And then also, the AV turret. Oh, no, you're good. That wall, there's good and bad things about each wall. Yeah, you do. I can teach you how to get that if you want. It's pretty easy. But, okay, so to do it is, first you need to get a silo. You don't need to put... No, you're good. First, let's go to your directives. Oops. It's under, just let's go to your directives. Oops. It's under strategic, under construction. Okay, and then go to Adapt, which is level 2 under construction. And I always get the harvesting, deposit coding, and repairing. Oh, we're under attack. Don't worry, we're good. Oh, we got enemies. If allies are spawning at the base, that means there's a good fight coming our way. And I always keep the silo full. Like, I'm paranoid about that. Oh yeah, that's what I've been waiting for.